In this video, I'm going to be going over how to host a website on iPage step by step from start to finish. I'll also be providing you with an iPage web hosting discount that will get you up to 75% off iPage hosting plus a free domain name. Let's get started with the iPage tutorial going over how to host a website on iPage. The first thing you want to do to get started with hosting your website on iPage is to click the link in the description below so you can be taken to iPage and so you can take advantage of getting up to 75% off plus a free domain name. A little disclosure, the link is an affiliate link, meaning I receive a commission from iPage at no extra cost to you. Plus, you'll get an awesome iPage discount. Once you click the link in the description below, you'll be on the iPage homepage. Click the Get Started button. You'll now be on the domain page where you can choose a free domain name. You'll see over to the right under your cart section, the save 75%. You'll see 3 years being selected. Click this and you can also choose a 2-year term or a 1-year term. You'll get the greatest discount with a 3-year term. You'll get iPage hosting for $199 a month. If you go with the 2-year term, you'll get hosting for $249 a month. If you choose the 1-year term, you'll get iPage web hosting for $299 a month. Choose a term you'd like to go with. For this tutorial, I'm going to choose the 12-month term. Now let's choose a free domain name. If you already have a domain name, you can just enter in the search field to continue with the domain you already have registered somewhere else. Once you type in a domain name that you want for free, you'll be on a page saying if it is available or not. Under the domain section, you'll see Add Domain Privacy Plus Protection being selected. This is an extra add-on that is completely optional. I highly recommend going with the domain privacy as this will protect your personal information from the public and can protect you from getting lots of spam and telemarketers reaching out to you via email and phone to sell you their services. When a domain name is registered, it is required, regardless of the company you go with, that your personal information be included in the public Whois database. By choosing Domain Privacy Plus Protection, instead of your information showing, it'll show iPage's information protecting you. Over to the right under the Your Cart section, you will see the free domain name showing and the Domain Privacy Plus Protection if you decide to choose this. Click the Continue to Add-ons button. We will now be on the iPage add-ons page where you can select any add-ons you'd like to go with. All these add-ons are completely optional and you can even add these at a later time in the iPage dashboard. You'll get a cheaper price for them now if you get them when you initially buy your iPage web hosting. So just something to keep in mind. The first add-on is Website Backup and Restore. This can be a good add-on to have as it'll back up your site daily so that if you mess something up by accident or your site gets hacked, or anything takes place, you can simply restore your site with a click of a button from the previous backup or a backup of your choosing. You'll notice this add-on is added to the cart by default. You can click the X button if you don't want to include this add-on. The next add-on is SiteLock. SiteLock protects your site from malicious attacks and hackers and from getting malware on your site. You'll receive daily malware scans, blacklist monitoring, which ensures your site doesn't get blacklisted by the search engines if your site does have a virus. It'll block automated bot attacks. It includes automatic malware removal. SiteLock can be good as it'll protect your site, and if something does happen where it gets hacked, you won't be left trying to fix and find the malware. You'll notice this add-on is added by default. You can click the X button and remove this add-on if you don't want it. The next add-on is Google Workspace. With this add-on, you'll get access to an email address ending in the domain name that you went with. Along with that, you'll also get access to their storage, calendars, video meetings, and more business solutions. Google Workspace runs as low as $6 a month. Your iPage hosting account will come with a free email address ending in your domain name, so unless you really want the Google Workspace features, I don't recommend this add-on. Next, click the Continue to Billing button over on the right. You'll now be on the billing and payment information page. You want to enter your billing information and then enter your payment information. You can also make a payment via PayPal if you'd prefer. Click the Buy Now button. You've now successfully purchased iPage web hosting. iPage will now email you your receipt along with login details so you can log into the iPage dashboard and you can continue creating your site. Once logged into iPage, you'll be on this page here. You'll see the domain name you registered for free. click Manage, and you'll be taken to the iPage summary page. Two of the most popular ways to build and create your website with iPage is via the iPage website builder, which uses a drag and drop editor, making the website creation process quick and easy. The other way is by using the popular site building platform, WordPress. You'll see over on the right, Site Builder, and underneath, Website Builder and WordPress. If you click Website Builder, it'll take you to this page and you just need to click View Plans. Next, click the Create Website button and you can begin creating your site with the iPage Website Builder. It starts off asking you a few questions. If you want to use WordPress for building your site, click WordPress. Click the Get Started button. Next, click the Use Existing button to use the iPage hosting plan you signed up with. Next, put in your site title name. Click Continue. Next, put in your email, a username, and password you want to use for your WordPress account. Click the Install WordPress button. You'll now be on the WordPress page. You'll see to the right the settings area. The site name will say queued right when you get to this page and then will switch to running shortly after. Once the WordPress install is complete, it'll say the title of your site. Next, click Manage Site. You'll now be taken to the WordPress login page. Once you input your login information, you'll be in the WordPress dashboard where you can begin in creating your site. That is my iPage tutorial on how to host a website on iPage. Give this video a thumbs up and leave us a comment letting us know if the tutorial was helpful or not, as the comments help improve our tutorials. Be sure to subscribe to our channel for more iPage web hosting tutorial videos.